Hey, hello everyone, welcome back. So in our today's tutorial, I'll show you how to create a tab bar menu in Android Kotlin. So without wasting much time, let's start our tutorial. So as you can see, this is our demo application and this is our tab bar which we are going to create in our today's tutorial. When we click on this tab bar, it will display us the five options. The middle option is to close the tab bar again, and again we will click on tab bar and it will be expanded. And here we are having remaining four options. So these are the four options with, through which we can navigate to other activities or fragments. So first one is item 1, and second one is item 2, and vice versa for item 3 and item 4. So this type of navigation bar we will create in our today's tutorial. So let's start. So head back to Android Studio and create an empty Kotlin project, and I had given it name as tab bar menu. So when you will change your project structure to project, it will display in this type of structure. And if you will expand, you will find your main Kotlin file and the main XML file. And under the values folder, you will find the color, string and style.xml files. Basically, the color file is for to assign the colors, primary, all types of colors to your project, and vice versa for strings and styles. So in order to create this type of menu, tab menu bar, we need to use external libraries, right? So for that, just go to Chrome and search for tab bar menu, and you will find this library which is created by Michael, right? So just copy this maven.url link, jpeg link, and paste it into your build.gradle file under repository section in this way. And after that, just copy this implementation dependency of this library and paste it into the another build.gradle file at the end under the dependency section. After that, sync your project. After successfully syncing your project, now your project will be ready to create this type of tab bar menu, right? So now let's design the layout for our this tab bar menu. So change your root layout to relative layout, and then add the frame layout. Frame layout is used to hold this this navigation bar, right? This button. For that, we'll create a frame layout. And after that, use this tab bar menu. Tab bar menu is nothing but this circle button. When we click on this button, it will display the items of that tab bar, right? So first of all, we'll create tab bar menu and give the parameters as per your wish, such as background color, gravity, height and width. And after that, we will create an image view. Now, image view is nothing but these items of menu. These four are the image views, right? So we will create the image views, two at the left side, and then we'll use some space for in the navigation drawer, and then we'll create more two image views, right? So these four image views are nothing but the menu items that we can see here, two at right and two at left. Now our XML file is ready. Our layout file is ready. Now let's go to our main Kotlin file and let's do some backend coding, right? So first of all, I had declared here five variables in let init type, which is of let init type. First one is for the variable of tab bar menu, and then I am having four image views, right? So four variables for that four image views, and then I had assigned this all the five variables the values that I had declared in my XML file, right? The four variables for four image views and one for tab bar menu, and then I had performed the on click listener on all the five items, right? Now and here I had created two functions. First one, first function performs the toggle of my tab bar menu. Toggle means nothing but when you will click on this tab bar menu, it will expand all these four items, and if you again click on this, it will disclose them. So this is known as toggle, right? So in first function, tab bar dot toggle method I had called, and this function has been called by tab bar menu. When I will click on tab bar menu, it will expand, right? Now let's go to our image views. Now here I had created one more function which is named as on menu item click, and I had passed the view in its constructor, right? And in curly brackets I had given tab bar menu dot close, which means it will disclose the all the items when if it has been expanded before. For example, now it has been expanded, and now if I again the center of click on center of the navigation bar, then it will disclose them. So this is known as close method. And then I had given here when condition. If you are working with Java, you must use your switch statement. but as I'm working with Kotlin, I'll use your when condition, right? And then here view.id I had passed into the when, which means id means which is id of my view that I had passed in this constructor. And then if this id is item 1, at that time it will display the toast message as item 1 has been selected, vice versa, same as for item 2 and item 3 and item 4. Now this method will be called by all these image views, all four image views. This method will call, for example, as you can see, this item 1 is the first image view that is displayed at the left side, and when I click on this image view, it will call this menu item click listener, and item 1 will be passed as the view, right? So in this and the same concept will be followed by item 2, item 3 and item 4. So in this way you can create this type of navigation tab navigation bar in Android Kotlin. The same steps you can use with Java. So hope you like this tutorial, and thanks for watching.